Friends, the last few lessons we have been studying the verb. The verbs have been discussed in three tenses. We have also seen the tense mark and also conjugated many types of verbs with all the persons and numbers and genders. We are supposed to be thorough with words. Continuing the same trend, we did see the categories of verbs. Number one, transitive verb. Number two, intransitive verb. There also we had so many types of verbs which did undergo some change while accepting the tense markers. And there were verbs where we had to bring in a new suffix to cement the root, tense marker and the person marker. Now we are going to take up another variety of verb, or I would like to call it an extension of a verb. As we saw earlier, a verb has two functions. Number one, the action. Number two, the tense. A finite verb has three components, namely the action part, the tense part, and the person part. That is to say, the last part will give us the details of the subject. The person, singular or plural, masculine or feminine, all these details are obtained from the person marker available in a conjugated verb, in a finite verb. We saw earlier, conjunction. You remember? Conjunction serves the purpose of bringing two nouns together. And in English we have this, and in Tamil we have, oh. We did see there is a difference between the use of and in English and om in Tamil. The and is added between two nouns. If there are more than two nouns, and is put before the last noun. Whereas in Tamil, we did add this om to both the nouns. Like this, avan is one word and non is another word. These two are to be combined and we made use of om in both the places. Both of them are pronouns. Instead of pronouns you can have proper nouns too. Here also you will have the same principle applied, that is, um being added to both nouns. We shall take up verbs. Veni, vidi, visi. You remember these words? They mean, as you know, I came, I saw, I conquered. Came, saw, and conquered. The comma is put between these three to indicate that they are three different verbs to be connected if need be. If you are to connect them, you will put and here. This is the method followed in English. Now, this is a verb. This is a verb, and this also is a verb. This is a finite verb, a finite verb, and a finite verb. That is to say, like nouns, even verbs can be added, can be put together with a conjunction in between. Can we do it in Tamil? He came and went. This is an example where you have a conjunction combining two verbs. Suppose I have it in Tamil. Vandhan Chandran. I have to add to both the verbs. Since they are verbs, I cannot add this, because this Vandhan plus Chandran plus Vandhanum Chandranum would mean a person. Remember the person marker. This person marker on indicates that this is third person singular masculine gender. So once you add a conjunction between these two verbs, they sound in every aspect a noun. So in Tamil, we don't combine two verbs with the conjunction om. Then what do we do? Again, we resort to English. When we read verbs in English, we try to read the different forms of it. The present tense form, the past tense form, and the future tense form. So also, when we were taught the verbs earlier, in the beginning, we were taught one present, past, and past participle. We did not know what that past participle meant for quite some time. and then we learn, pick it up. Go, present tense, went, past tense, will go, future tense. Suppose I want to make it a perfect, present perfect, then I have to use